Introducing Glenn Johnson.
So here comes Glenn Johnson wearing his 305 hard hat, representing Miami and his beloved Miami Heat. And at 42 years old, Al, you've been in boxing for over 30 years. What a great story regarding this man.
I've said this before. If you don't like Glenn Johnson, you don't like people. He's a great guy. He is still fighting at an extraordinarily high level. He's fighting at an extraordinarily high level at the age of 42. And he is a man that represents the best in boxing.
So Glenn Johnson, after dismantling Allen Green, his beautiful wife, Jillian Hall Johnson, and Antonio, you fought the man twice. The first time he won a split decision. The second time you won a unanimous decision. You always talk, when we refer to him, about the internal part of Glenn Johnson.
Yeah, you know, in fighting sometimes it's more mental than anything. And Glenn Johnson, with the pressure he has and he applies, it breaks you down mentally as well as physically. And he has that hard hat on tonight for a reason, because he comes to work tonight, baby. He knows it's going to be tough.
Hey, he was a construction worker, literally with a full-time job still until 2004 when he beat Roy Jones Jr. So that's a worker.
Ladies and gentlemen, from England, Carl Froch.
Nottingham, England's own Carl Froch, who some feel, especially in Great Britain, that he is a Robin Hood type. He's trying to get into the final of the Super Six, but he's also putting his belt on the line, his WBC world title that he lost to Mikkel Kessler and then regained. Carl Froch continues to show his unbelievable improvement fight after fight as he takes on all comers.
I think that's one of the stories of this tournament, the fact that we've seen different skill sets from Carl Froch. Antonio was the first one to really say it, that there are boxing skills in this man that were subtle and nuanced that the average person might not see.
Yeah, you know what, if you ever watch a tape of Carl Froch as an opponent, you might have a tendency to underestimate him. But that'll be a big mistake, because this guy does everything well.
Now, Carl Froch did ask you some interesting questions as you take a look at his girlfriend, Rachel Cordingley. They recently had a son, Rocco. Carl Froch hasn't seen Rocco in 3 weeks, and he can't wait, as he told us, to go home, see his baby with his title and an invitation to the Super Six final against Andre Ward. We'll talk about the conversation you had with Carl Froch as we left our meeting room yesterday in a moment. But right now, we're ready for Froch and Glenn Johnson as we look at the numbers and the tail of the tape.
Now, for Carl Froch, that height advantage, though there is no reach advantage, is important for him. He's got a huge ring to work with. It's almost 24 feet on the inside. He's going to use it all. He wants a fight at distance. And the fact that Glenn Johnson came in so far under the 168-pound limit, a pound and a half when he fights at 175, some people say is a warning sign.
And a look at the rules for tonight's fight.
No standing eight, no three knockdown rule. Of course, only the referee can stop the fight. Can't be saved by the bell in any round. And if there's a clash of heads that would cause the fight to be stopped before the completion of round four, it would be a no decision. After that, they would go to the scorecards.
And we are ready now for Carl Froch versus Glenn Johnson for the WBC Super Middleweight Championship of the World and a place in the Super Six World Boxing Classic Final. Let's get the official introductions from our ring announcer, the classy Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ooh. Ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening to you, and welcome to Boardwalk Hall here in Atlantic City, New Jersey, for the featured bout of the evening, brought to you by DiBella Entertainment and Warriors Boxing Promotions in association with Caesars Atlantic City, Matchroom, and Showtime. This bout coming away is sanctioned by the World Boxing Council. The president, Jose Sulaiman, the supervisor, is Chuck Williams of Hawaii, along with the New Jersey State Athletic Control Board. The chairman, Tony Orlando. The commissioner is Aaron Davis. Introducing to you our physicians at ringside tonight, Doctors Stephen Oxler, Blair Bergen, Vincent Guida, and Dominic Coletta. And our timekeeper at the bell is Arthur Spell. Introducing our three judges, scoring from ringside. From England, Mark Green. From the United States, John Stewart. And from Japan, Nobuaki Uratani. And our third man of the ring, the referee in charge of the bout, he'll be giving instructions after the introductions, Earl Brown. All right, fans, here we go with the main event of the evening. 12 rounds of boxing for the WBC Super Middleweight Championship of the World and for the Super 6 World Boxing Classic Semifinals. And now, ladies and gentlemen in attendance and boxing fans joining us around the world, live from Atlantic City, New Jersey, it's showtime! Introducing to you first, the challenger on my right, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing white trunks with red trim, from Miami, Florida, by way of Clarendon, Jamaica. He weighed in at a trim and ready 166.5 pounds, with a record of 51 wins, 14 losses, and 2 draws. He has 35 wins coming by way of knockout. Here is the challenger, currently ranked the WBC number 2 world super middleweight contender. Please welcome the former light heavyweight champion of the world, known as the Road Warrior, introducing Glenn Johnson. And his opponent across the ring is the defending world champion, fighting out of the red corner, wearing black trunks, known as boxing's pride of Nottingham, England. He weighed in at 167.5 pounds, with a record of 27 wins, only 1 defeat. He has 20 wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the reigning and defending 2-time WBC super middleweight champion of the world, introducing Carl the Cobra Frost. Once again, a referee in charge. Now to give instructions, Earl Brown.
Glenn, call. You've received your instructions in the dressing room. Obey my commands at all times. Protect yourselves at all times. Anything from here down will be considered low. Anything from here down will be considered low. Gentlemen, let's do it.
So we are ready for the WBC World Title and the Super 6 World Boxing Classic Semifinal. What a win this would be for Glenn Johnson. In 2 fights, he wins a world championship and has a chance to go after Andre Ward's belt and the Super 6 World Boxing Classic title. Meanwhile, Carl Froch has taken on all comers. He continues to step up his skill level. He has the heart of a warrior, but this may be his toughest fight against a true warrior in Glenn Johnson. Round one.
The first round will be fascinating. How much will Glenn Johnson attack? Will he be attacking with more abandon than we think? This is a lot of questions here. And again, we mentioned the ring. It is monstrously big, which could help Froch.
Yeah, when I look at this ring, I call it a Sugar Ray Leonard, Marvin Hagler ring, because, you know, Sugar Ray needed distance back in the day.
And Al, in your opinion,
almost comparable media careers between Marvin Hagler and Glenn Johnson.
Yeah, in some respects, you know, people didn't give Hagler as much as great as he was, didn't always get the breaks when it came to decisions in some cases, and maybe wasn't thought of as big a superstar as he was.
Glenn Johnson, yesterday in our meeting, as he wears his Miami Heat boxing trunks, looks like LeBron could wear them right now himself. He was so calm, Antonio, so relaxed, almost jocular in his responses to what he can do against Carl Frye.
Yes, he was, and I was expecting him to be that way. But before the fighters meeting ended, Carl Frye pulled me to the side and he asked me a question straight up. How did I beat Glenn Johnson?
Oh, interesting.
That led me to believe that he had some concerns about fighting this tough guy, Glenn Johnson.
A very tactical first round, and Glenn Johnson has been careful how he's attacked, and Frotch has not thrown a million counterpunches either at this point.
Well, Antonio, did you tell him how to beat Glenn Johnson? What did you say?
I told him what worked for me. You know what I'm saying? I gave him angles. I was up under all his big shots all night long, but I didn't run. And right now, it looks like Carl Frotch has chosen to meet Glenn Johnson head-to-head.
But a different pace, Al, for Glenn Johnson at the start of this fight than we've seen in the past?
Generally, yes. And he might be taking a round to figure him out, but he's certainly not attacking with as much abandon as we usually see.
A relaxed Carl Frotch, stiff jab landing on the chin of Johnson. That backs him up. And the Cobra, Antonio, as you told us the other day, he is slick.
Yeah, he is real slick right there. He's comfortable. And it's important for a fighter to be able to stand in the heat and also be comfortable at the same time, relax. But I tell you what, Glenn Johnson has a monstrous right hand. You know he knocked out Allen Green with it, and he also stretched Roy Jones with it. Right now, he's licking his chop, looking at Frotch's left hand so low.
And it's that looping overhand right, a punch that was very effective for Mikkel Kessler in his comeback win tonight in Denmark. Round one, scheduled for 12, the super middleweight WBC world title and super six semi. And that takes us to the keys for tonight.
Well, Carl Frotch wants to stay at long range, use his jab and right hand. He was able to control the distance perfectly in round one. Now he drops his left hand, which Antonio pointed out, and it's the overhand right that will try and get there for Johnson. The Frotch uppercut has been in mothballs during this tournament, but I think it will resurface again this evening. Now for Johnson, he's got to get on the inside. Didn't do that in the first round. And he's got to throw those double left hooks to the body and head. And then there's that overhead right that Antonio referenced. He could hurt Frotch with that punch.
All right, the quietest man in our broadcast team right now is Andre Ward, the champion, as you take a look at his picture coming off the big win against Arthur Abraham. First round, what have you seen, champ, between one of the men that you will face in your next fight?
I like Glenn Johnson in that round. I think he was inching closer. He was just missing with that big right hand. And I think he's got Carl Frotch a little confused at the moment.
Were you surprised at Glenn Johnson's pace? He usually starts a little bit quicker.
Well, Carl Frotch is a solid puncher, and he's just got to be careful. You know, I looked at Glenn Johnson when he came out. He was very dry. He's sweating good now, but he was dry. So I don't know if he was just trying to warm up or what it was, but I think that was his round.
And, champ, when we talked in the dressing room before the fight, you were concerned with Glenn Johnson's weight and how that could affect him.
Well, you know, reason being is that he didn't really have a tough fight with Allen Green. And now I'm looking at this pace. This is not going to really press or stretch Glenn Johnson. He can go at this pace all night long. I thought Frotch would come out, put the jab, be more aggressive to really stretch Glenn Johnson. He's comfortable in there right now.
Glenn Johnson jogging yesterday on the boardwalk here in Atlantic City at 42 years old, didn't have problems making weight. He said, I'm a hard worker. This is what I do all the time. I just wanted to shake it out and get loose.
You know, early in this fight, Glenn Johnson said, I've got to get to the body. He's starting a little bit now with some jabs to the body. There, you see that? He wants to work the body of Frotch early, so there's not a lot of movement.
And as you mentioned, Antonio and Al, Carl Frotch keeps that left hand dangerously low for a nice right-handed puncher like a Glenn Johnson.
And Jermaine Taylor knocked him down with a right hand.
Carl Frotch has fought a murderous schedule. He beat Jean Pascal in Nottingham, England, then came all the way to the United States, was knocked down by Jermaine Taylor and ended up stopping Taylor late to retain his title. He started the Super Six, won a close decision against Andre Durrell, then lost a war against Mikkel Kessler. Right hand landing for Johnson as Carl Froch steps off, and then he performed brilliantly against Arthur Abraham.
It looks like Carl Froch is opening up a little bit here. He landed a Chris left hook, but again, I think Glenn Johnson is just a little bit too close right now. I'll be nervous.
Well, you know, he hasn't been able to get right on the inside where he likes to dig those body shots, but here he is now. This is where he needs to work, right there, Johnson. That's what he likes.
And Froch ties him up, tries to work the free hand.
Expect to see Froch hold a lot on the inside.
Froch told us if Johnson comes in, he's going to use his jab, work angle, step off, throw the left hook under and over, and try to set up the straight right hand down the middle. Now a looping right hand. Here's a left hook to the body under.
Come round the side of that right hook. And that's what I'm asking him to do now is 1-2, 1-2 hook, and then beat him to it when you're inside. Okay? But ideally, you hit him with a reach move, you think, well, you've got to counter him. Okay? You've got to counter him, okay? Listen to me. Jab, jab, right hand.
He's going to hit it. Because right now he's comfortable. He thinks all there is. Right. He thinks all there is a jab to the body, but when you sneak that right hand, when you feel comfortable, it's going to pay off. And the only thing is, when you get him up against the rope, be careful not to get over anxious and fall in. All right? Because you know once he gets up against the ropes, he panics. And when he panics, he's going to do a couple movements. Don't fall in. Go ahead, champ. You're looking good. Keep that jab out. Just watch his right hand over your jab. That's all you got to watch out. His jab over
your
right
hand. That, of course, is Orlando Cuellar, the fine trainer of Glenn Johnson, who was up for Trainer of the Year this year, although Freddie Roach won it, which he seems to do every year. And Robert McCracken, the very fine trainer also of Carl Froch.
McCracken, 33-2 as a professional, the former British Commonwealth middleweight champion, retired in 2001 after losing to Keith Owens of Washington, D.C. Now some good jabs to start.
Yeah, I was going to say, Glenn Johnson discovered that punch here right now.
I feel like the tide right now is going to change. These guys right now is going to draw that line in the sand, and they're getting ready to fight right now.
Well, Glenn Johnson's made the difference, right? He has decided really to attack now, so I think he's going to turn the fight on now.
Andre, your thoughts about what you're seeing at the start of the third?
Well, I agree with Antonio. Things are starting to heat up, and Carl Froch is not a pure boxer. He's really a fighter, so he's getting forced to fight right now, so we're going to see how he responds in this moment.
Nice stiff jab by Glenn Johnson as he stalks, goes to the body with the jab. Keeping his guard up high. Froch got the right hand through. Froch now starting to move a little bit. Johnson invading his space. And that's what he does, Antonio. You know.
Yes, he does. And you can see he's applying the pressure. That's that right hand that we talked about earlier.
And that hurt Froch. The right hand hurt Froch.
You know, Froch has really been winning this round with his punches, but you knew, you felt Johnson was going to land something important, and he did.
Glenn Johnson told us that he is going to knock Froch out. It won't take him long. Froch's hands all the way down, below his waist. Could he be tired?
Like I said in the opening, it's not about skill, but it's about will. And right now, Glenn Johnson is forcing his will on Froch. He's fighting a fast pace. I don't know if Froch is ready for this one tonight.
Glenn Johnson hired a nutritionist, lost the weight, and put on muscle at 42. He said he stopped eating bad food. He got serious because he knows that this is his opportunity, especially, Al, when you consider the landscape at 168.
Yeah, this is his career's reborn. Now, let's remember, Carl Froch is landing a lot of punches here. So he's still doing well offensively, but you get the feeling that Glenn Johnson, as we said, is imposing his will. And now he's starting to work the body, Glenn Johnson, which is important.
Froch looking over into his corner at
Robert McCracken.
Great, great. No budget. No budget.
And Andre, how much has that Glenn Johnson jab to the body, right to the solar plexus, affected Carl Froch?
Well, that's a body shot. You know, a lot of people underestimate that shot. I use that shot a lot. It's a body shot from long range. But even more than that, the jab from Glenn Johnson to the nose of Carl Froch is you know, it's paying dividends right now.
This is a good fight. Both men landing big shots.
Left hook by Froch as he pivots. And that's the end of the round. It's starting to heat up here in Atlantic City, folks. One of the legendary places for boxing in our country.
It really is, and this man here has been involved in some big ones here. Now, in the last round, Glenn Johnson landed that right hand kind of on the side of the head, and it, much like he did against Alan Green, and then he followed up with yet another one. And you see Froch using all of this ring. But Froch landed some very nice punches during the course of this round and threw some very good combinations, and that was an example right there of it.
This is the Super 6 World Boxing Classic semifinal. The winner to advance to the final to take on Andre Ward, who's sitting with us right now. It's also the WBC World title fight as well. The champion is Carl Froch in the black trunks. The challenger is Glenn Johnson in the Miami Heat trunks, who are now tied one apiece with the Dallas Mavericks in the NBA Finals. Fourth round. Scheduled for 12. Glenn Johnson barely missing with that looping right hand.
Yeah, you know, when I first thought about this, the keys to victory here, I said Froch is going to have to do some lateral movement. He's going to have to turn Glenn Johnson. He's going backwards in a straight line and giving Glenn Johnson all opportunities. He's going to have to adjust his game plan if he wants to win this fight tonight.
Press row scoring. You see everybody with a one-point win for Froch at this juncture. Mike Coppinger, USAT, Keith Idick from the Bergen City Record, and Ron Lewis from the Times of London. I have it a draw, actually, at this point.
And you talked to Glenn Johnson. And yesterday, Al, you talked to Glenn Johnson about his inability against fighters that are on the rise to get decisions.
He's lost very close decisions. Last time he fought for the light heavyweight title against Cloud, he lost a very close decision. He knows that that happens to him a lot, and he's going to need to take control of a fight to win it.
Meanwhile, Carl Froch, Antonio, as you always talk about, he's got incredible heart. When the fight gets tough, he will dig down deep, and you'll see some of his best work.
Oh, yeah, he does definitely have a reserve. I mean, he's a champion, and he loves being champion. He has what we call swag, and the man is just, you know, he's confident. You know, he feels that he can beat any man on any given night.
What are you seeing so far, Andre?
I see Carl Froch getting a little bit more comfortable. He's starting to settle in a little bit. This fight is not a fight of skill. It's a fight of wills.
And, you know, the distance still favors Carl Froch. Glenn Johnson has never really fought off his chest in this fight, except for a few moments. And that's important for him at some point to do.
I see Froch making some adjustments. Glenn Johnson is right in front of him, but he's not having the success. See, right there, he went up under that jab and he countered. That's where you want to be. You want to pitch shot right there in front of Glenn Johnson.
Johnson slow with the left hook. Froch's reflexes, feline. Now Froch punches and punches as he steps away, takes his time, throws the big right hook block, but he stays busy.
You know, Glenn Johnson's not cutting the ring off. He's following Froch.
Glenn Johnson in the last two rounds looking a hair slow. Now don't forget, coming up July 9th, Showtime Championship Boxing has Brandon Rios defending his WBA lightweight belt against Urbano Antillon. And you really like this fight coming up?
I think it's going to be terrific. Antione in the fight of the year against Roberto Soto last year. Brandon Rios, he fought Miguel Acosta on our air. It was tremendous. That should be a war. And we're going to also see the highlights of Lucien Bouté's fight against Jean-Paul Mendy.
Okay. You have to be busy with this man. You cannot box single shots, do nothing, all right? Listen to me, Rock, how you feel? Let's be busy with it. Anything there, sure. Anything there, sure. Come.
We begin the fifth round. Glenn Johnson taking two deep breaths, getting off the stool, slowly. Cuellar, his trainer, saying, you got to get busy. You're not going to win a decision against Carl Froch. Ooh, nice right hand by Froch that gets through.
And that came after a counterpunch. It came off a counterpunch. Right now, Carl is comfortable right in front of Glenn Johnson. He's barely making a miss, and he's making him pay.
Total punches. You see that Froch throwing a little bit more than Glenn Johnson. And I'll tell you, Glenn Johnson is a volume puncher. So he wants to have more punches thrown than Carl Froch.
Glenn Johnson trying to get closer, using the jab. Now lands a right hand. Right hand to the body. Now tries to chop him up. And Carl Froch gets away.
There's the left to the body by Johnson. We haven't seen any double left hooks yet, and he needs that.
We just saw a nice uppercut that you mentioned, that the keys to victory for Froch, caught Glenn Johnson with it. The thing that's different now, and the reason why Johnson is not having that much success earlier, is he's having to reset. Carl Froch is moving just a little bit to throw him off and make him reset rather than landing and having leverage.
Absolutely, and I think Glenn Johnson, to a degree, is starting to slow down a little bit. I think the last round, he took a round off. He's trying to pick it up, but he's not the Glenn Johnson that we saw in the first two or three rounds.
And he came in very light for this fight. 166 and a half. He was dry to start, as you mentioned, Andre. Now, the quick hands of Carl Froch.
This is an important fight for Carl Froch. It's being sent back to England on Sky TV. It's the first time he has been seen on that kind of platform in Britain. He feels this needs to be a signature fight for him.
And it's ridiculous that his home country hasn't really gotten behind this kid. He is a wonderful champion.
Yeah, I agree.
Oh, big right hand by Froch. Uppercut. Carl Froch, another right hand. England, you got a guy here.
You gotta
pay attention.
you gotta love Froch, man. Woo! I mean, the guy got a heart that's biggest, you know, all. And you know, he's there. Like I said, he's not running, and that's how you beat Glenn Johnson.
Carl Froch also with some very choice words during our meeting, folks. For Andre Ward, the man sitting next to us. We'll talk about that in the next round.
Carl Froch landing some of his biggest punches of the fight so far. That is a beautiful right hand. And it shows also how resilient Glenn Johnson is. And then he tries the uppercut. And we take another look at that right hand over the kind of awkward and lower left of Glenn Johnson. And that was a big power punch for Carl Froch.
And with the Super 6 headed toward its championship final, we remind you, there's still time to fill out your own Super 6 bracket at sports.show.com/boxing. Pick the tournament champion and enter the sweepstakes for a chance to win a trip for four to the tournament final. Yesterday, when we were in our meeting talking to Carl Froch, Andre Ward, the champion, was not present, although he's present with us right now. Froch saying that an opportunity to fight Andre Ward would be his kind of fight because, Andre, you'd have to come to him as Glenn Johnson is right now. Your response?
I think Carl Frosch just needs to focus on what he's doing tonight and get this W. And if he's able to hold his end of the bargain, he's going to get what he's been asking for.
All right. Spoken like a true champion. Johnson and Frotch. Johnson in the Miami Heat, white, red, and gold. Frotch in black, the champion. This is for the super middleweight WBC world title, the champion, Carl Frotch from Nottingham, England.
To me, there's two salient points so far about this fight. One, Carl Frotch has never had to stand with Glenn Johnson fighting right off his chest. And two, Frotch has thrown more punches than Johnson. If those two things continue to happen, it'd be very tough for Johnson to win this fight.
And Carl Frotch has seemed like he's found a home for that 1-2.
Yep.
And another thing, look at Johnson's feet. He's walking. He's not galloping. And it takes him longer to close the gap. He needs to start moving rather than just walking in.
And our points are buttressed by the unofficial press row scoring. They all have Frotch winning this fight.
Frotch using his jab. He's been the matador from the very beginning. The uppercut has been effective, as well as the jab for Carl Frotch. He's been able to land the right hand when Johnson tries to get on his chest. There's a left hook, backs up Johnson. Glenn Johnson very flat-footed in the ring, folks. You don't see him on the balls of his feet. Three-punch combination for Frotch. Steps back.
You know, we keep thinking Glenn Johnson may get one of those right hands in, but the problem is he's reaching with that punch from pretty far out. Well, you see the amount of power punches and the fact that Frotch has the edge, and we know he's winning the battle with a jab. Not so good for Glenn Johnson.
Frotch backs up Johnson with a right cross.
And Frotch is relaxed in there, man. You see it all coming. You can see this is the slickness that I was telling you about. It's the deceptiveness. He's relaxed. His defense is working, and he's giving these little subtle movements that keeps
going. Big right hand by Johnson, though. Carl Frotch, though, walks right through it as he backs up. Now with a smirky smile on his face, the Englishman.
Does he have bravado or what?
I mean, honestly.
He says he may want to be an actor when his career is over. I hope Guy Ritchie is watching. He'd make a perfect thug in one of his movies.
Hey, Rachel says, I didn't like that right hand he got hit with, though.
Listen, you've got to beat him to inside, all right? You're letting him walk in and hit you around the body. Relax, put your legs out, all right? Listen to me. All right? That's halfway, all right? He's an old man. He's leaving his legs behind you. Relax, breathe.
Glenn Johnson did have a moment in that round, and that moment came courtesy of this right hand. That's the overhand right we talked about. It wasn't landed perfectly, but it was a good punch. But Frotch came back with a great left hook and some good combinations.
You're doing good work, but you know what? Remember, it's not good enough. You gotta stop him. Glenn is 7 is getting away. We have to stop this guy. You gotta start hurting him. When you get him in the corner, stop it.
And Andre Ward, Glenn Johnson looks tired on the stool.
This is the point we were all talking about before the fight. Is the weight issue going to have an effect on Glenn Johnson? You can make the weight, but can you be effective? I think that's what we're seeing now. It's similar to a fighter going to the gym and being flat. You start out strong, but then you realize, I just don't have it today, and that may be what Glenn Johnson is feeling right now.
And our Jim Gray is standing by with Andre Ward's trainer, the masterful Virgil Hunter.
All right, Gus, thank you very much. Virgil, what's your assessment so far of what you see in this fight?
Well, I see Carl Frotch pulling away in the fight. Glenn was pressing initially, and he was having a couple of good rounds, but I'm looking for him to go on a fourth and fifth gear, and he's not doing it. He had a moment in the last round. He landed a good right hand, but Frotch answered him right back. So if it continues like this, I see Frotch pulling away. Glenn is going to have to go into another gear. Whether or not he can do it, I don't know.
So if you were advising and training Glenn Johnson, what would you tell him in the corner in between rounds?
Well, I definitely would tell him to double up and triple up his jab to get where he has to. He has to step with his jab. He's reaching with his jab right now. He's looking for one big punch over the top. Now, whether or not that's their strategy or whether or not that's the only way he feels like he could win.
Double right hand.
Big right hand. Let's go back to Gus Johnson. Big right hand by Glenn Johnson, Gus.
Absolutely right, Jim Gray, but Carl Frotch comes right back throwing hooks, most of them blocked. Johnson trying to find a hole here in the seventh round. And Al Glenn Johnson has been in so many wars with so many great fighters.
See, right there is where Glenn Johnson wants to be. This is where he wants to make the fight. And he's going to have to make it there in these coming rounds if he's going to have any chance to win this fight.
Glenn Johnson is going to have to continue to go downstairs.
Yep.
You know, Carl Frotch is still winning this battle,
yes,
even though he's giving Glenn Johnson opportunities.
Here's a body shot by Johnson, but a left hook, right hand combination lands for Frotch. That pop.
This
hooking right hand by Frotch, followed by a straight right hand by Glenn Johnson.
We got a real fight now, though, because Glenn Johnson has carved out some inside territory. Frotch is still doing well, but Johnson's having more than his moments. Now it's a fight.
Has Johnson caught a second win, Andre Ward?
I think so. He's answering back every time Carl Frotch lands a good shot. This is the kind of fight that I anticipated, and that's why I've been calling it 50-50 from the start.
See, the body work. Yeah, I'm sorry, Gus. He has really now committed in this round to that.
Carl Frotch saying that he's in tip-top shape. He expected this kind of fight with Glenn Johnson, because when you fight Glenn, you're going to hit a little bit of everywhere.
Everywhere. It doesn't matter. He's not a pinpoint accuracy. Heart, arms, lungs, organs.
Miss Johnson, ringside. Concern on the faces of the ladies in the lives of these two prize fighters.
Glenn Johnson got himself back in this fight in some way. That's where he needed to be in terms of where he could throw that right hand. He was close. He was able to throw those chopping right hands. And we look at it again. Look at the distance. He's right there in front of Carl Frotch and doubles with the right hand and uses the jab. That's the Glenn Johnson that needs to surface in this fight if he's to have a shot at winning.
Open this guy. All right. Don't touch him up and then land those shots that mean something. All right, listen. Don't just walk in. Get behind the jam.
You go straight in the leg. And be sweet start all the time. Come on. Do you understand me? Come on. Don't fuck about. Come on. Let's get on it now. I mean it, Carl. Get on it now.
The eighth round, scheduled for 12 for the WBC World Championship. The title holder is Carl Frotch in black. The challenger is 42-year-old Glenn Johnson, a two-time champion himself who's moved down to 168. The winner to advance to the Super 6 World Boxing Classic Final to take on Andre Ward. Carl Frotch comes out strong to start the round.
This is what we wanted to see, and it's because Glenn Johnson has inched closer. Now he's fighting off Frotch's chest a lot, and it's making this a great fight. And give Frotch credit. He's firing back in these situations.
Johnson jabbing to the body. He's been throwing the straight right hand to the body as well.
A couple of Glenn Johnson's punches string a little low, too.
Carl Frotch with very long elbows. He's got the reach advantage, 75-inch reach for Carl Frotch.
You know, just a reminder, Glenn Johnson is 42 years of age, and he is in another war here. You got to give him a lot of credit for having the grit at that age to do this. Good hook by Johnson.
Right hand! Big right hand by Johnson. Backs up Frotch. Frotch fighting off the ropes now. Carl Frotch buying a little time. Did it hurt him?
Those body shots are very hard inside. This is the type of fight that I knew Glenn Johnson could have.
Another right hand by Johnson. Frotch coming back. Left hook, right hand, Frotch. Now he's covering up his body. Left hook, double left hook by Johnson. Woo! The old man still has something in the tank.
Did somebody say fight of the year?
I think it was you. Might have been you.
Johnson, eighth round.
You can press this round in your memory book. It's a good one.
Carl Froch showing no ill effects as he lands a left hook and backs up. What a round, this eighth round. Double jab by Johnson.
Very, very tough round to score right now, Gus.
Oh! You got it. Did Glenn Johnson punch himself out a little and all that?
Breathing out of his mouth now, Johnson. For the final 10 seconds, rolls the right hand. No knockdowns in this fight thus far, and that's the end of the round. And they got busy, folks, and the fans in Atlantic City very appreciative, many of them on their feet.
Glenn Johnson had big moments in this round. Very good straight running. And there's the double left hook, the two weapons that we said he had to use. Now, Froch, meanwhile, landed lots of good counter punches as well. That's what made that a very close round, as Antonio said, a tough one to score. Later on in the round, there's the distance between the two fighters. Glenn Johnson could land those double left hooks because he was right there.
Yeah, but you credit to Froch. Every time Glenn Johnson get off, he fires right back.
You're right.
He's not giving him any ground.
Champ, your thoughts as well.
No, I agree with Antonio 100%. I think Froch is doing just enough to stay ahead, and the key is he's answering when he gets hit. That's what you want to see in a champion.
Froch, slow off the stool. To start the ninth round scheduled for 12, this is a Super 6 World Boxing Classic semifinal. Glenn Johnson in white. Carl Froch in black. It's also for the WBC World Championship, Carl Froch's belt.
So far, Gus, it doesn't seem like the weight problem or issue is affecting Glenn Johnson. But this is the type of fight, a hard fight like this, in these championship rounds. We're going to see, can he keep this pace up?
Punch stats from the last round.
And you see how active both fighters were and how well Glenn Johnson did, edging out Froch in total number landed.
So far, Froch has controlled this particular round, and we're a minute down already.
Right hand to the body, followed by a short left uppercut to the solar plexus by Glenn Johnson. Right hand again by Johnson. Froch, though, what a chin. What a chin by this tough Englishman.
Again, he answered back with combinations. You've got to take the head off to the champ. This is how we want to see a champion fight.
Carl Froch, warrior.
And when Johnson's on the inside now, he's not as active as he was in the last couple of rounds. See, he's in there, but he's not able to get those punches off.
Right hand missing by Johnson as Froch ties him up. Now Glenn Johnson moving a little quicker with a minute and four remaining to go in the ninth round.
Glenn having moments, but it's those accumulation of combinations that has Froch ahead in this round.
Yep, that's exactly right. Next to the word grit in the dictionary is the picture of these two men.
Yeah. They know it's at stake. This is a pass to the Super 6 final to face the champion that I'm sitting next to, Andre Ward. And this thing gets bigger, man.
Yeah. And Andre Ward's looking at this, a fight of attrition, Andre. You like this, don't you?
I like it a lot.
A lot of those punches blocked by Glenn Johnson. But Carl Froch being active and busy. And that could affect
how the judges see the round.
Most definitely. And I know Glenn Johnson is saying, I'm chopping at this tree. When will it fall?
Rachel Cordingley, the girlfriend and the mother of Carl Froch's son, Rocco.
Hey, Gus, I'm trying to figure out, where did they get the muzzle from? We haven't heard all night.
I told you, Glenn, if he fires five, you got to answer right back. All you did was you blew that round completely. Completely, you didn't do anything. All you did was follow around.
Single throttle jab. That's the only time he ever hits you with a right hand. Just in and out, three shots move, and then three shots again. As soon as you lean inside, I'll lead you straight under there with them short body shots. Put it on his head. Put it on him. Mate, listen to me. I want real sharp boxing. Carl, he's 42, he's really feeling it now. But he's going to look for that right hand, all right? One, two, make him miss and count him. And any time you lean inside, you've got to beat him to it there. Come on, mate, I need you busy. Come on, deep breath, let's go. Come on, come on, come on.
What happens, Antonio, when you're older and you get to the later rounds of a fight?
I don't know.
$250.
Shoot, you're only 31, aren't you?
That's great.
That's what I refer to as an Antonio Tarverism. Well, if history tells us something, Carl Froch is 6-1 in 12-round fights, and Glenn Johnson is 5-7-1. So going the distance favors Carl Froch, obviously.
There's time in this fight that Carl Froch has everything going his way, and then he relaxes and he let Glenn Johnson have a moment or two that really sparks him and energizes him. He got to stay on top of Glenn Johnson.
And Andre Ward, I love the way Carl Froch lets his hands go, even though there may not be an opening when he does it.
Well, when you fight guys like Arthur Abraham, Glenn Johnson, you got to create openings by punching. You can't wait because they're not going to give you anything. And you're right, he's doing the right thing. He's staying steady.
Beautiful right hand by Johnson, right on the button. That backs up Froch. Did it hurt him? No, Froch punched out of it. And he steps up. Carl Froch, folks, is a tough, tough man. He has taken some shots in this fight.
And part of this is Glenn Johnson is not a one-punch knockout artist. And so even though he's a light heavyweight, a real light heavyweight, he hasn't been able to hurt Froch badly with that right hand.
Froch now smiling at Johnson. And Antonio, you told him that Glenn Johnson was going to take him to places that he'd never been.
And what I meant by that was mentally. It's hard. If you never fought before, for a guy, it's hard enough as boxing already. But when you got a guy in your face coming and hitting you everywhere, man, that's defeating in itself. So Carl Froch is strong tonight physically as well as mentally.
Another right hand by Johnson, right on the chin of Froch. And if Glenn Johnson was determined to take Carl Froch's places he had never been so far, Al Bernstein, it looks like Carl Froch was willing to go.
He was, and he had the mental toughness, as Antonio said, to get past it. And more importantly, Carl Froch has thrown the combinations tonight, and Glenn Johnson hasn't.
Yeah, we knew coming in, Glenn Johnson is not a combination puncher. He was going to wear you down in the body, and again, that signature overhand right that he's had some success.
Beautiful jab by Froch that backed up Glenn Johnson, also snapped his head.
What we see from Glenn, though, a lot of times is when he gets on the inside, he works very well. Hasn't been able to do that effectively through most of this fight.
And that's the other out. And that's Glenn Johnson's wife. How many times has she been ringside for one of his wars? And we were talking about some of the fighters that Johnson has faced in his career.
Yeah, everybody from Antonio Tarver, Bernard Hopkins, just every name you can imagine. Now, in this last round, again, there's a right hand by Johnson. He's landed, I'm going to say, 8 or 9 of those that have been significant. But every time Froch does this, he comes back with a bunch of punches. And that is the reason why Froch has sustained in this fight and stayed ahead. And Froch came back to with some good combinations. Flurries that, when he throws those combinations, they're very hard. seconds.
Here, hit your back. You need both these rounds and you've got a good shot. Come on. And he's looking for the right hand. Get on it. Stop messing with him.
Last minute instructions for Robert McCracken as Frotch gets off the stool quickly. We enter the championship round. The 11th round scheduled for 12 of the WBC World Super Middleweight title. That's 168 pounds. This is also the semifinal of the Super 6 World Boxing Classic. Carl Frotch, the WBC champion, taking on Glenn Johnson, a late add in white. The winner to take on Andre Ward in the final.
You know, I have to believe that Glenn Johnson felt coming into this fight. He was the bigger, stronger man, and that if he caught Frotch with a couple of those right hands, that he would hurt him and maybe knock him down, maybe knock him out. But, man, I think Glenn Johnson's learned tonight that Carl Frotch is a guy that's a proud champion and that he's willing to go the distance and the limit to get the victory.
And I'm sure you saw Taylor knock him down with the right and said, I'm a bigger man. There's the number of combinations, and that says volumes, because Carl Frotch, with those combinations, has controlled this fight, even though Glenn Johnson has had some wonderful moments.
Left hook gets through. The last punch of a four-point combination. Oh. Right hand by Johnson. Frotch walks through it.
That was the best punch of the night for Glenn Johnson, and Carl Frotch ate it.
Frotch with some swelling under his right eye. Left hook Johnson.
Wow.
Up jab Frotch. Glenn Johnson more urgent now.
I'm going to say it again. I know Carl Frotch is winning this fight, and he deserves huge credit. 42-year-old Glenn Johnson still in there warring with this young man.
You know, Glenn Johnson understands what's at stake.
Yeah.
He understands that, you know, if a loss here, he may never get an opportunity like this, Al. And that's why you see this guy laying it all on the line, and I commend him.
With all these 168-pound fights out there, he knows for him to get another one, he's got to do something impressive. Yeah, you're right, Antonio.
Lucien Boutte, Mikkel Kessler, Andre Ward, Carl Frotch, Kelly Pavlik now moving up to 168 pounds.
Mm-hmm.
There are some very talented fighters in this division.
And you know, Arthur Abraham, despite his recent lack of success, is going to go back to Germany and have a big fight. He might want to do that with Glenn Johnson.
And I also want to point out, guys, that, you know, Carl Frotch told us about the type of conditioning he was in. I mean, you have to feel that this guy's in phenomenal shape tonight to be able to withstand his punishment.
And he just ate two more right hands from Johnson and kept coming forward.
And he's still there.
Wow. What an effort by both men.
What are you seeing, Andre Ward, with 10 seconds remaining in the 11th round?
I see a brutal battle. Both these guys are going to war. Carl Frotch has got the, he's asserting his dominance, but this is a brutal fight.
Well, we'll see part of why the fans who have come here from across the pond very happy what their man is doing, but it has not been easy. Good left hook. This is this fight in microcosm, with Johnson coming forward, Frotch landing big punches, but then Johnson able to get in those right hands. Every time Frotch answers with these combinations on the inside. Lucien Boutte, the IBF super middleweight champ, who is waiting to meet somebody of note in the super middleweight division, and certainly wants a shot perhaps at the winner of this tournament. Man, is this division loaded, isn't it?
Loaded. Between Carl Frotch, the champion, and 42-year-old Glenn Johnson, the challenger, the winner to advance to the Super 6 World Boxing Classic Final to take on Andre Ward.
Looking back at this tournament, Carl Frotch has been involved in perhaps two of the best fights in the tournament, against Mikkel Kessler and now against Glenn Johnson. So he has provided us with a lot of excitement.
Yes, and he's involved, man, into a real, real solid champion. I mean, it's going to take a guy like Andre Ward to really stop a guy like Frotch. And I'm glad, I feel right now, it's 106, 103 on my scorecard. I feel that Glenn Johnson needs a knockout if he's going to take away this title from Frotch.
Well, his trainer, Orlando Cuellar, calling for a knockout for Glenn Johnson. Now Frotch still using that jab. It's like a whip. Long arms. Goes downstairs. Frotch relaxed from the very beginning, and boy, did he take some shots.
And the problem Glenn Johnson has is he's landed some thunderous right hands that have not hurt Frotch. So it's got to be a little distressing. He's probably wondering, yeah, I may still land some more, but will they hurt him?
Yeah, and I think those punches coming back at him might have something to do with it.
It's been a good 12th round for Carl Frotch.
And when you look at Carl Frotch's style, guys, have you ever seen an Englishman with this kind of boxing style?
He says he fights like an American because he's loosey-goosey, he's awkward. He's not the classic British stand-up stylist.
Yeah, you know, I saw great things in Carl Frotch, a while back, and like I say, deceptive. I mean, because you really can't see his greatness.
There's the uppercut. We were waiting for that to really emerge, and it finally did. He's knocked people out with that uppercut, Frotch.
But I'll tell you what, Al, I think it's his chin that is his biggest asset.
Yes.
I mean, because when a guy can take punches like this, you know, how do you stop him?
40 seconds remaining in the 12th and final round in the Super 6 World Boxing Classic semifinal. Also for the WBC world title held by the champion Carl Frotch in black. And he has been excellent this evening. The Cobra on top of his game, maybe 20 seconds away from meeting Andre Ward as they will combine both titles, actually three titles, for a winner-take-all showdown. Two young men in their prime. Carl Frotch, Glenn Johnson, go 12 hard rounds. And the fans here in Atlantic City, very appreciative.
I'll tell you what, Gus. By my scorecard, Carl Frotch swept the championship rounds.
I agree. And, you know, this man, Glenn Johnson, who gave a tremendous effort here tonight, deserves a lot of credit. And you know what? Both men tonight, I think, represent boxing so well. This is what boxing's all about.
No holding. No grabbing. Nothing illegal. No walking. Great inside fighting.
Wow.
And you can see the respect on the faces of both men as they come together in center ring.
Now, Inside NASCAR, the fastest half hour on television, is new episodes every Wednesday at 9 p.m. and an encore presentation following our show tonight. Carl Frotch. Wow. What a string of fights that he has gotten through. We'll go back. He beat Jean Pascal, who just lost his title at 175, to the great Bernard Hopkins. As you take a look at the punch stats.
And the fact that Frotch out threw Glenn Johnson in this fight is really an important, noteworthy thing, because Glenn Johnson's a volume puncher.
And again, guys, it's something I know that's very, very difficult for any fighter, is to go abroad and fight this way. I mean, this man feels that ring is his domain.
Mm-hmm.
And no matter where is the fight take place at. And that's a different type of champion.
And remember, he did it well against Jermaine Taylor in the United States, did it here tonight, and fought very well against Kessler in Denmark.
Glenn Johnson with a dejected look on his face. Carl Frotch, has he done it again? Let's go inside the ring for the decision and our Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 rounds of action, we have a majority decision. Here are the score totals. Judging ringside, Nobuaki Uratani scores the bout 114 to 114, even a draw. overruled by judges John Stewart, who sees the mount 117 to 111, and Mark Green, who scores the mount 116 to 112 in favor of the winner advancing to the tournament finals. And still, the WBC Super Middleweight Champion of the World, the Cobra Froch.
The Cobra does it again on foreign soil as he wins a majority decision over Glenn Johnson and now advances to the Super Six World Boxing Classic Final, where he'll take on Andre Ward, and he retains his WBC championship as well, and he's in the ring with our Jim Gray.
All right, Gus, thank you very much. Carl, congratulations. What's your assessment of this fight? This was a heck of a battle.
Yeah, it was very tough, very strong and durable. He's one of them guys you hit. And if you can imagine sort of sparring an oak tree, that's the only way I can put it into perspective. You hit him, he doesn't move, he's solid, he keeps coming forward. You don't feel like the shots hurt, so you then tend to stop throwing the hard, hurtful shots and just work on picking your shots steadily and sort of getting through the round. And then you get into the comfort zone of just, you can't get out of that gear of just being steady and, you know, comfortable, which is what I was in. I stepped it up towards the end, made sure I won. I don't know what the 114 score was, the Japanese judge. I think that was a bad score, to be honest. 117, 112 was more realistic, but all credit to Glenn Johnson. I mean, what a tough, strong, durable man. I hit him with some big shots.
Were you ever hurt in this fight? It seemed like he was able to hit you with his right hand pretty regularly.
He hit him with a couple of right. Was it that regular, was it?
Well, it seemed to be, but I wasn't receiving it.
That's not good news. Hit him with a couple of shots, yeah, the right hands. No, they didn't bother me. They caught me off balance a little bit, to be fair. Obviously, you feel the shots. He's a big, strong man. Them little 10-ounce gloves, they hurt. So you feel it, but I'm known for having quite a strong chin. The only man to put me down on the floor was Jermaine Taylor, and that was an accumulation of a couple of shots and a balance thing more than anything else. I've been blessed with a strong chin.
And, would you say that's perhaps your best asset?
No. It's an asset that's very valuable, but it's not your best asset, because if it was your best asset, Glenn Johnson would have won this evening, wouldn't he? Because he's got the biggest, strongest jaw in the business. I'm sure he has.
Carl, stand by. We're going to talk to you and Andre Ward, who you'll face next, but let's bring in Glenn Johnson. Glenn, you're 42 years of age. A very representative, terrific fight. Did you feel as though you would win this decision, or did you feel as though the judges have it correct?
I felt I was in it, you know, and when it's close like that, I really don't know. My corner was telling me to pick it up because I was falling behind, so I was believing what they was telling me, so I was trying to pick it up, but it kind of take me out of my game plan a little bit, because I get in there and starting to rip hard shots. I was able to allow him to come back with quick counter punches while I was on the inside. I started out boxing properly, which was the way I was supposed to fight the fight. You know, I was supposed to fight the fight from that distance because I was faster than him. I was able to hit him at will. But when I went on the inside trying to land the bigger punches, I kind of put him in the fight. He was able to come right back with quick counter punches. And you know, I was blocking most of them, but we know, you know, when you do stuff like that, the judge is going to give him credit just for effort, so that kind of take me out of the fight a little bit.
You came in at 166 and a half. You've come down in weight. Was that a factor in this fight? And your power shots were hitting. You were able to hit him with your right hand repeatedly, but did that loss of weight and coming down affect your ability to possibly knock him out?
I don't believe so. I don't believe so. In my heart, I don't think so, but, you know, who knows? But I don't really believe that. I believe that I was fine. I felt strong. I just felt like I kind of fell into his fight plan a little bit more than sticking with mine, just because I got a little greedy.
At this age now, 42, what will you do going forward?
Well, you tell me. Did you like the way I represent myself tonight?
Excellent. So astonishing.
Do you think I should move forward?
I believe you should, but I'm not the one taking the blows, and I'm not the one doing the training.
That's all right. You work for one of the best network in boxing, and if you want to see me again, that means your network should want to see me again, and that means the people should want to see me again. So I'm still in it.
I believe the people will want to see you again. Thanks Glenn.
Appreciate
great fight
it.
All right, let's now bring in Andre Ward, who will now put up his titles against the man who has the other titles. Here it is. These two guys right here will face off in the fall to be the Super Six, Super Middleweight Champion. Andre, what is your assessment? We had you on of this fight here tonight?
Well, it was a tough, grueling fight. I mean, both men got hit with some big shots. Both men answered back, and that's what a champion is supposed to do and a former champion in Glenn Johnson is supposed to do. So I wasn't surprised at all, and that's why I've called it 50-50 from the start.
You guys are two of the Super Six originals. You said before the fight you thought the people wanted this and you wanted this. Why?
Well, I just think, again, you know, stylistically it makes sense. And once again, like you mentioned, we're the guys who started off in this tournament. So I think it was natural that and it's fitting that we be the guys in the finals.
Now, Carl, and we're going to speak to him, told Gus Johnson, Antonio and Al yesterday that he feels as though he can beat you and that he has the formula. Moving forward is not something that you can handle. He believes he's going to win the fight, so it already started yesterday before this fight. What's your response to that?
Well, he's supposed to feel that way. It would be wrong if he felt any other way, but I feel the same way. Everybody feels they have a formula, but like I always say, when these lights turn on, it's a matter about who can get it done, and that's what it boils down to.
What did you learn tonight? It seemed as though Johnson, and I was sitting with Virgil Hunter, your trainer, seemed as though Johnson was able to hit him with that right hand almost repeatedly.
Well, I'm not going to go into it too much, but, you know, obviously Carl Froch gave up some sucker shots. And what I mean by that is shots that are just he didn't have to get hit with. But, again, to his credit, he battled back and he did what he had to do. So how can you be mad at him?
You can't. Carl, let me ask you. You made the statement to the guys yesterday that you feel as though going forward that you have the formula to beat Andre Ward. What is the formula and why did you say that?
Well, me and my trainer have got the formula. You'll find out why I said that when we box, you know, and it's going to be a great sporting occasion. You know, the Super Six final, two of the original six lineup. You know, it's the only autograph I've not got on the glove. I'll be getting it off him in the final. I've been saving it because I knew that it'd be me and Ward in the final. And I'm looking forward to it. And I feel I can beat him. As he said, I'm sure he feels he can beat me. I'm a WBC Super Middleweight champion. This guy's a WBA champion. This is going to be an unbelievable final. He beat Mikel Kessler, a guy that beat me. I don't feel he did enough to win. It wasn't a fantastic one-sided performance. And I feel I got the best of Kessler. And I'd love that rematch. That's another fight I want. But let's get to the Super 6 final first. You know, Carl Froch and Andre Ward, what an exciting prospect, what an exciting fight. WBC, WBA champion. This is what the tournament's about. This is what the sport's about. And let's not forget, it's a sport. It's a great sport. It's a sport that we both love. Olympic gold medalist, you know, world championship bronze medalist here. Amateurs different to professionals. We all know that. We've had Olympic gold medalist fail, Audley Harrison. We've had another guy fail recently, James Gale. You know, Olympic gold medals don't win world championship and dominate world championship level. We know that. But he's a top amateur. I'm a top amateur. We're both top professionals and both in the Super 6 final. So let's enjoy it. I believe I can win. I know I can beat this guy. You know, on my night, I know I can beat this guy. But we're both that good. It's that much, you know. We might fight each other 10 times and it might be 5-all. On the night's what counts.
Would you let me have an answer that long, Jim?
Absolutely. Go ahead.
No, it's the grand finale. And I think, you know, everybody's said enough. This is what everybody's been wanting. This is what everybody's been clamoring for. So it's time to get it on. We fought the best over the last 2 years, year and a half, or whatever it's been. Two titles are going on the line, and I want that trophy in my trophy case. So, you know, and obviously he's going to try to stop that from happening. So that's what makes this fight so big.
Gentlemen, we look forward to this fall. May the best man win. Congratulations, Carl. Andre, we will see you this fall.